And that's my response to that question.
No, take it up.
And then lastly, just to follow up one other time. So you're happy that Vic took enough control of the fight? Vic did everything that he could have done as an official, in your opinion, to control the fight short of making a DQ?
You know, I think Vic did the best job he can do. I think, just like the chairman said, come Monday morning, we'll go over the fight, we'll review it. We'll see what we could have done better. We'll see what we did right. I mean, in that particular fight, you know, you can take a look at the judges. The judges were in agreement in the majority, 87.5% of the time. In the WBA final, the judges were in agreement over, I think, 92% of the time. So, you know, we take a look at everything that we do. In the beginning, before a fight, and at the end, then we'll go ahead and reevaluate our positions. But I think Vic did the best he could do, and I think he really made a concerted effort to take control of that fight, which was evident by the number of points that he took from both fighters.
I think the main question for me, and I'm curious what both you gentlemen think, is why then and why Diego Chaves? In other words, why did he do it then and why specifically Chaves in that moment? Did he explain why?
I think there was a question of whether or not there was an intentional foul occurring early on in the fight. That was brought up to the ref's attention. He spoke to both corners about it. And then when he saw the forearm go to the forehead, he then made that decision at that point in time.
You know, Al, in addition to your question, also was brought to Vic's attention that Mr. Chaves allegedly was gouging at the face of Mr. Rios, at his eyes, and things of that nature. That's an egregious foul. Vic didn't see it. The corner brought it to his attention. Vic then went over to Mr. Chavez's corner and told him, hey, look, I didn't see this. It was brought to my attention. You keep this type of action up, you're going to be disqualified. Then the round went ahead and kicked off, and as Chairman Aguilar stated, they got locked in close, and he threw an elbow through to the throat or the forehead. You know, we didn't have 16 cameras to look at it, but you know, from our vantage point, that's what Vic saw.
But Bob, if to follow up on your answer, then if you're saying that he never saw the gouge to the eye, and then the first time he saw it was when he ultimately disqualified.
No, he didn't say that.
Thank you.
He said it was an elbow.
Right.
That he disqualified.
Right, but he was
not a gouge to the eye.
He was saying it was a gouge to the eye.
He said he was warned.
No, what I had just stated was that it was brought to Vic's attention about the eyes from the Rios corner. Vic did not see that. He went over to the Chavez corner and explained to him that type of action is not going to be permitted. Then the round, the bell rings, and the round continues. They get close, they get clinched, and he throws a forearm, according to Vic, and either Vic said it hit him in the throat or the jaw or something, and he said, all right, I've had enough. That's it. I'm disqualifying you.
And Miguel, you know, just was in the corner of Chavez, said that before the ninth round, Vic went over and said exactly what Bob said that he said.
It's also to the overall control in the ring, and when both fighters aren't respecting the authority in that ring, you're gonna run into some safety issues.
Okay,
Mi nombre es Osvaldo Rivero, soy representante, apoderado y amigo de Diego Chaves.
He's Osvaldo Rivero, he's Diego Chaves' promoter and friend.
Hace 30 minutos que estamos tratando de hablar de la pelea. Hay un concepto en el deporte generalizado. Hay un concepto generalizado en el deporte que el mejor referí, ya sea en boxeo, en fútbol, en básquet, es el que pasa desapercibido. ¿No?
We've been discussing for almost 30 minutes about all this, and there is a main concept in soccer, basketball, boxing, that the referee is like in a Spanish thing, that is there, but you don't see him.
En este caso no se habló de la pelea, de quién fue el mejor boxeador, quién hizo las cosas bien, quién hizo las cosas mal. Solamente estamos hablando de la figura principal, que es el referee. No pasó para nada desapercibido. Piénsenlo un poquito, nada más.
In this case, we are not talking about boxers, about what Diego did and what Rios did, and we are all talking about the referee.
I'll be happy to answer that, unless you want to take it, boss. sorry about that. Do I need a translator? I know my.
Well, this is like the influence of the World Cup, you know. This is the first boxing match after the World Cup, big boxing match, and the referee gave Diego a red card.
I don't say anything about your sister. Did you say, what did I say about your sister?
When she, you finished talking.
Oh, in response to a question.
No.
Would you like
to take something? Yep. Everybody laugh.
No, in response to your question, sir. Depending upon the fight, you know, sometimes the referee, you don't see him because it's predicated on the actions of the fighters. You know, quite frankly, in Las Vegas, you know, ask around the country, we've got some of the best, if not the best, referees in the world right here. In this particular fight, when the fighters aren't listening and following the direction of the referee, and it becomes a health and safety issue for the fighter, naturally you're going to see the referee get involved more often than you would if the fighters would adhere and listen to the referee. Therefore, unfortunately, the referee had to do his job, and he was involved in the action more often than, quite frankly, he would have liked to have been. And I say that with all due respect to you and your fighter and
thank you,
the unfortunate
Bob.
Situation.
It's getting real late here. I want to thank everybody for coming. I want to thank the Cosmopolitan for being such a great host. And I want to tell